Hi everyone, a very warm evening to each and every one of you who's joining us today. And very happy that you could take out time on of course a hectic Friday. So my name is Parul Srivastav and I'm the strategic operations specialist with CIALFO, and I'm excited and very, very psyched to welcome you to do today's webinar, which is all about summer schools in India. It's all about Edu-fun in the Indian sun. So we all know that summer schools offer a bunch of different benefits, right from providing an avenue for academic enrichment to allowing students to delve into subjects that they're passionate about, and also to sort of explore new areas of interest in a rather relaxed and supportive environment, right? So, in addition to that, they also foster personal growth and independence by encouraging students to step out of their comfort zones. So overall, we know and we do agree that summer schools not only supplement traditional education, but they also nurture a very holistic, development, preparing students for future academic and professional endeavors. So this evening, what we've decided is that we'll introduce you to some amazing summer programs from a bunch of wonderful different, Indian universities. So what we'll do is that we'll be starting the presentation, starting with the South region, and then we'll go on and cover different regions of, India as well. So first and foremost, I am very happy to welcome Mr. Suman Banerjee, who from Alliance University. We have Mr. Abhyuday Roy from Atlas Skill Tech University. Next up, we have Ms. Ashwini Sakpal from Ecole Intuit Lab. We also have from Universal AI University, Ms. Vani Bhalla. Next up, we have Ms. Priyanka Saklani from Plaksha University, Dr. Anurag Goswami from Bennett University. And last but not the least, we have Ms. Pushpa Joshi from GD Goenka University. I welcome you all and thank you once again for taking out time out of your busy schedules to just speak to our students and apprise them of what exactly does your university offer in terms of summer schools. So the first speaker that we have for today is Professor Suman Banerjee. Now, Professor Suman Banerjee is an assistant professor at Alliance University. He holds a Master of Design degree from the National Institute of Design, Ahmedabad, with a specialization in film and communication design. Professor Suman has worked in various capacities as an academician and administrator at various institutions in India and abroad. He's also worked as a media consultant and designer with several government and non-governmental organizations, including the World Bank. And he's also developed a series of documentaries on social issues. So over to you, Professor Banerjee. Please go ahead and share.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And I would like to welcome everybody who's here that I've joined right now. I am speaking on behalf of Alliance University. And as you all know that this summer we have fun-packed program which is to be offered to all the students from India and from abroad anywhere. So may I share the screen to show a bit about Alliance University? So then we can proceed ahead with our summer program. Some details about the summer program. And here we are. I hope that you can all see the screen here in front of you.
Yes.
Yep. Okay, fine, that's great. So let me introduce Alliance University. And our university is the first private university in the southern state of India. And we have been in operation for the last 28 years now. And School of Design have just started operating from 2023 onwards. And this time we are offering a summer school, which is fun-packed primarily by the School of Design, but we will be covering and introducing you to all the schools the university has. We have a full residential summer program, which has been offered here in Alliance University, which is here in Bangalore. And it is open for all the students from India and abroad from class 9 to 12. And this program is uniquely designed to expose the young minds to the challenges of the real world through interdisciplinary and experimental engagements. By experimental engagements, I mean you would be not only just listening and watching us, but you will be involved into doing a lot of work, which is maybe critical thinking exercises, problem solving issues or just fun-filled craft activity. So the activities what we would be taking care of, there would be a lot of skill workshops, there would be a lot of career guidelines and pathways showing you. There will be a series of talk series by experts who's from different walk of life. There will be thematic sessions based upon crafts or music or entertainment or anything like that. There will be a lot of group projects, fitness programs, cultural activity, personal activity. We will be doing a lot of skill workshops on, say, silk screen printing, to block printing, to pottery making, to painting, to filmmaking. There will be a full day of making film. We have a full day of animation workshop. Other than that, we have calligraphy workshop and all the creative possible workshops, whatever you could think about, is all there. And every evening is, we have arranged for a lot of sports activity, because I have learned that the kids from the 9 to 12 are very much into active sports. So we have a huge campus sizing approximately 65 acres all around. And we have about 8 to 9 outdoor sports and altogether about 21 total sports zones in the campus, which includes indoor and outdoor sports both together. So and a nice experience is going to be there to be here. It's a 10-day long workshop, and we would be holding it this summer twice, which is one in the month of May, which is starting from 9th of May to 18th of May. The batch two would start from June 15th to June 24th. And everyone can join. And just let me show you what we had last year, how we had gone through it. That was about the last year's summer program, what we had. And I would like to also take you to another short glimpse of, it's just a 30 seconds, another 30 seconds of the last year's. So that's about what the students' reaction was from the last year. And finally, this is what some details you might be interested in. Am I running short of time? I don't know. We would be inviting everybody from class 9 to 12. The program fee is 15,000, which is all inclusive, which includes accommodation, all 4 meals of the day, a welcome kit certificate, and all the activities. And there are a lot of industry visits and industry interaction. All of them, which is including in 15,000. Okay, so that's about my presentation. Thank you very much. I hope I have covered it in time. Have I?
Definitely.
If there is any question, do I answer it right now or should I wait till the end of it?
So I'm just going to request the students to please start using the Q&A section and the chat box. So, depending upon how and when the students have a question from you, they could either ask you right away or maybe also towards the end during the Q&A section.
Absolutely fine with me.
Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot, Professor Banerjee. Next up, we have Abhyuday Roy from Atlas Skill Tech University. Now, Abhyuday Roy is a management professional with a cumulative experience of over 15 years working in India and abroad. He represents ISTI School of Design, Atlas Skill Tech University, as the Associate Director of Outreach and Admissions. Working with people from different levels and parts of the world has enriched his diaspora of knowledge. He's been a part of the design education fraternity for over a decade now. Having counseled over 10,000 design aspirants, he's today equipped to help design enthusiasts with any and every query. So over to you, Abhyuday.
Thank you so much, Parul. I believe everyone can hear me well. And Thank you everyone for joining in, and welcome to all my colleagues from different universities who are here. Let me take this opportunity to not only introduce you to the design summer program that we have this year, but you also have two other programs, and I'll try to be as quick as I can. As Parul introduced, we are Atlas Kiltech University. We are in the heart of Mumbai, if some of you might not be aware of. We are in the heart of Mumbai, just adjacent to BKC, which is Bandra Kurla Complex. And that's why we are not a large, plush, green campus, but we are a vertical campus, as you can see on the screen. And we are three schools, right? So the three schools that we have is the School of Design, with which we started off back in 2013. This is our 11th year, and this was started in collaboration with Parsons. We have a School for Management and Entrepreneurship, which is ISME. This runs in collaboration with Babson, and we have a School for Digital Technology, which is UGDX, right? And this year, we have a summer school for all the three, okay? And not only design, Design Summer School has been running since 2013 itself, and we have had some 5,000 kids go through our Design Summer School over the years from all parts of the country. So I'll start off with the Design Summer School and then follow the chronology of design, then management, and finally the tech school. So yes, at the Atlas Summer Schools, you would learn, you would be immersed, and you would be engaged, right? The eligibility for all the three schools summers programs is from class 9 till 12. So all the students who are graduating from 8 to 9 would become eligible, and all the students who are in their 12 right now would become eligible. Not the ones who have given their exam or their boards are any longer eligible, okay? Because we every year get such requests. So I'm just trying to make that clear on here. The Design Summer School is in collaboration with Parsons and is certified by Parsons, which is one of the key takeaways, because Parsons itself certifies this 10-day program that we run for the Design School. All the three programs are of 10 days each, actually 12 days, because there's a weekend in between that comes in. The Design Summer School is where we would try and guide you to be university ready, right? And this is also an area where you can figure out whether design is your calling or not, right? If you are interested in design, you must have heard, seen, but probably not experienced design in itself, doing it with your own hands. You must be great in crafts, you can be great in drawing, sketching, or animation, or so many things. But is design your calling? Okay. This is where you figure it out. Okay. This would also encompass your presentation skills, your leaderships, your storytelling, and all the formats that is required for you to becoming a world-class aspirant. Okay. And to apply to us and maybe to so many other different places. This is where you understand different design disciplines, okay? And how we would do that, this is the academic curriculum for the Design Summer Program, where there will be portfolio curation, there will be illustration in spaces, there will be brand and campaign, material digitech, animation and film, there will be image photography, public speaking, product and tech mag, storytelling, fashion and styling. So all the facets of or the pathways of design would be covered through interactive sessions. Students get bifurcated by their classes. We would have small batches of 25 to 30 at the max in each batch. And students would work along. There would be mentors for each group. And there would be workshops. You would have a tangible product at the end of each day. And these products would eventually become a part of your portfolio and the showcase that the student put up in the end or the graduating day, all right? We have three batches for the Design Summer School starting on 20th of May. The second batch would start on 3rd of June. The third batch is more made for the IB and IGCSE students, which starts from 24th of June, goes on till 5th of July. Coming to the management summer school, it is the first time that we are doing a management summer school this year, because we have got requests from all quarters of educators, students, and parents. So we finally thought this is time that we start a pure management summer school. This is where we are trying to find out and prep future leaders, entrepreneurs, and this is where your journey starts to become a world-class management professional, right? You would be getting through the syllabus of being an entrepreneur, going through finance and accounting, marketing, digital, digitech, and business analytics. You would also be networking. And I believe networking is one thing which goes without saying for all the different summer school. If it is design, you meet your like-minded designers. If it is the management summer school, you would meet like-minded students from across the country, right? And you form bonds which probably last for a lifetime, and you make great friends, and you find out what the other person probably from other part of the country is doing, or how they are developing their portfolio or resume, right? Or their statement of purpose. We have two batches for the management summer school, which is on 20th of May, and the second batch is on 24th of June. Coming to the final one, which is the tech summer school. This is again 10 days. All, as I mentioned earlier, all the three are for 10 days each. This is an AI and machine learning summer school where you would be taught from Python to using AI and auto tune and predicting future, modeling, image processing, conversing with the computer, generative AI. Your AI odyssey actually begins here. Okay. The world is moving towards AI in a much faster pace than probably we can think of. And all the tech enthusiasts are invited to be a part of this tech summer school. You all can find details on our website. For the tech summer school, we also do have only two batches, which is same 20th of May, and the other one is on the 17th of June to 27th of June. All right. And now we have our own hostel. The if you can follow my cursor, the tall building on the right of the screen is our hostel, which is just across the road. This is Holistic Living. Since we are in Bombay, this is not, as I said, a holistic residential campus. But yeah, we have made the best that there can be in the heart of Mumbai, right? We have a vertical campus. There are sporting facilities alongside the university. There are sporting facilities and cafes and arenas and lounge. All of that is available in the hostel as well. Gym, and everything that you can think of. Food is by Sodexo. There is world-class upkeep by JLL. The security is top-notch. There would be utmost care that the wardens and would take care of all the children who come and stay with us in the hostel, all right? The boys and girls would have separate floors, and they are all biometric driven, so no one gets to enter each other's floors. There is attendant at each floor, so the security, as I said, is top-notch. There is ample amount of entertainment available on the hostel, where there is enough amount of indoor sporting facility. The outdoor sporting facility is inside, near, next to the university building. There's a turf. So yeah, this is the best that you can get in the heart of Mumbai. And on that note, I'll stop here, and questions I'll answer whenever and as and when they come. I'll leave the link for application on the chat box. All of you can access them from the chat box itself.
Thanks a
lot. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you, Parul.
Thank you so much, Abhyuday. So I'm hoping, I'm assuming all the students, everyone in the audience is already taking notes. And, you know, I hope you're all ready with your questions already. So next up in line, we have Ashwini Sakpal from Equal Intuit Lab. Ashwini is a seasoned professional who harbors a deep-seated passion for education with a solid decade of industry experience under her belt. She currently holds the esteemed position of Head of Counseling and Admissions at Equal Intuit Lab, a highly regarded institution in the domain of design education. Ashwini's career has been enriched by her past associations with prominent organizations, and today she enthusiastically paves the way for talented individuals, guiding them towards a trajectory of success within the creative corridors of Equal Intuit Lab. Thank you, and over to you, Ashwini.
Thank you so much, Parul. If you can allow me to share my screen.
Yeah, sure.
Dedicated for our animation and illustration. So this whole summer school, whole 10 days, there is a theme, and the theme is self-portrait. So first day, after learning the principles and fundamentals of design, then you start working on the theme. So here, the theme is self-portrait. So your animation is going to be, your illustration is going to be a process-based. You'll do a lot of processes to draw yourself. Okay, and then the same process, the same paper is then we are going to convert it into animation of your own face. So here, that's how we finish animation and illustration. Then 13th May is hand lettering. Very, very, very important topic in design. Typography and hand lettering is key subject in our visual communication. Lot of brands get success just based on their typo frame. So this whole day is focused where you will be drawing your own name in different lettering format. Then moving ahead, 14th to 15th May is character design. So someone who is interested in gaming, but right now they're confused whether, you know, gaming interests me, whether convincing their parent is a still a struggle. So you can come, you can, you know, join this workshop. You get to know whether this industry interests you or makes you excited, gives you excitement. So this 14th and 15th May, again, this workshop will have a lot of processes. You'll do a lot of characters, different body shapes, different emotions, different, elements. And then we migrated into the digital learning. 16-17, we cannot leave artificial intelligence this time, because now the speed at which AI is taking over, we thought of including ChatGPT and Midjourney in our workshop. But like the name says, it's AI for young minds. So it's not going to be a thorough artificial intelligence workshop, but you will be able to learn what is ChatGPT, what is Midjourney, and you'll be able to create basic projects. Come on, you guys are in 9th standard, you guys are in 12th standard. Right now, you know, knowing this will help you to understand, and you'll be able to implement these softwares in your current education as well. So this is the flow. So I'm going again for my previous slide. So first workshop is foundation study. So like I said, 5 workshops, and Saturday, Sunday, it's off. This workshop is starting on 6th May. The summer school is starting on 6th May. It is ending on 17th May. And then you have an exhibition. So we will showcase your exhibition. We'll call your friends. We'll call your family. And you'll have to explain your work to your, parents. It's a nice opportunity for you to also understand the presentation skills, because being a designer is one thing, but pitching your, giving pitches to your clients, making presentation and talking about your work, explaining about your work, selling your portfolio is again a skill which is very important in design. So that we will do it in exhibition. Now, this is some of the work of our students. Just for you to see what kind of work we do. This is a package designing. Again, package designing. This is something related to gaming. This is our senior students' work. This is UI UX, book design. Now, who is going to take this workshop? So for summer school, all my faculties are industry experts. So they are already working in an industry. They are the art directors. They are the brand consultants. They are technical artists. They are creative directors from the industry. So they will teach you whatever happening in an industry. They will help you to understand the current trends. They will able to, get you connected. So connecting with faculty is again a takeaway. So what you will get after completing this summer school, number one, you get a certificate, which is very important. You get it from the French Design School, Ecole & Tweet Lab. Number two, you get your portfolio ready. So, some of you would be 9th standard, 12th, 10th standard. Every design school, be it Ecole & Tweet Lab, be it Atlas Kiltic University, every school has a design entrance. So this portfolio will be helpful for you to pitch in your, to get ready. You can show this work as a portfolio for your design entrance interview. Now, with this faculty, you will also be able to get a lot of industry connections. So you'll know a lot of people from the industry. And plus, last but not the least, a lot of fun. So you'll make new friends. It's always good to, come and, spend your time productively. And we are located. So these are the brands our faculties have worked on. These are some of the brands. The faculties are associated directly, indirectly with these brands. This is the kind of a campus life which I wanted to highlight. So, we celebrate all the days. We go out on picnics. We go out on treks. All the days are celebrated. This is the last summer school batch certification. And for admissions, yes, I am also going to put my direct link in the chat box for you to apply. And it's a very simple process. You need to fill out the application form. The summer school fees is 15,000 inclusive all the taxes. And the intake is 30 students per batch. And the dates are 6th May to 17th May. I will wait here. And I would love to hear any questions. If you have, please do not hesitate to, put it in the chat box. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot, Ashwini, for that wonderful presentation and showing some of the amazing designs that the students have been working on. Next up, we have Ishan Ahuja, who is the manager of admissions at Universal AI University. Ishan brings over 6 years of experience in the higher education segment with a background in English and also with a master's degree in English literature. Ishan also holds a master's in digital marketing, combining a passion for education and digital innovation. Over to you, Ishan.
Thank you, Parul. So a very good evening to all of you. My name is Ishan Ahuja, and I am manager of admissions at Universal AI University, which is India's first AI university. We are located in the beautiful valley of Karjat in Maharashtra. So before going, moving ahead towards the summer school, let's first of all quickly know more about the university, what we are. So I'm sharing the screen with you all so you can have an idea what Universal AI is all about. All right. So yeah, this was majorly what we are. As we say, we are India's first AI university and of course, a university with a soul. So now if I am to tell you a bit about our summer schools that we are going to offer to the students. So the summer school, first of all, would be targeted to the students of, 9th, 10th, 11th and 12th class, number one. Apart from it, we do not have a kind of a very fixed kind, program for the students. Now it is a customized program for all the students. So for example, if you are a group of students or batch of students who want to come on campus, choose the specialization or the kind of program you want to go for, and we would be happy to customize it for you guys. The time span of this summer school would be in the month of June and July over the weekends. So it's a residential summer school. You will be staying on campus with us. You will be exploring the campus. You will be learning more about, you will be diving into the world of AI. You will be working with the professionals of the world of AI. You will be working with the professional of the world of commerce. All right. Apart from that, you will also be exploring the nearby areas. For example, we have a film city near us, or the Essel water park, which is amongst the best in India as of now. So we will be giving you a exploration of everything that we have to offer for the students. So you want to come in groups, you're most welcome. Plan it according to your own wish, whichever programs you want to go for, choose that, and we are more than happy to customize it according to the batch of students. So we are not, but what thing I can assure you is, once you're done with this open house, you will definitely be more and more inclined, or you'll be more and more aware of what AI holds for the students in the future. So yeah, I will be sharing all the details about Universal AI University, the summer school that we are offering to the students, how you can register for it, or in case you want to directly connect with me or my team, I will be sharing the details in the chat with you. I'm happy to assist all of you. Thank you so much. Thank you, Paru.
Thank you. Thank you, Ishan. Next up, we have Priyanka Saklani, who's the lead at Plaksha University. She is an avid technology enthusiast with over 10 years of expertise in overseeing robotics, STEM, and skill development education initiatives. Which are basically tailored for the K-12 education section. She's committed to crafting impactful programs centered on addressing real-world challenges through technology. Over to you, Priyanka.
Yeah, very good evening, all of you. And thank you, Kelfo, for having me here. So before, going further into YTS, I would also like to make you understand that Plaksha University is a tech university, but the offerings are very unique because it's focusing majorly on interdisciplinary technology curriculum, which is integrated with not just, technology or sciences, but also with liberal arts, design aspects and hand-on pedagogy, and also self-development of the kids. Moving ahead to YTS, it's a flagship program of summer program of Plaksha University. It is a two-week program. It's a two-week immersive program, which again provides the flavor of Plaksha's, as I just explained, exciting hands-on and interdisciplinary learning curriculum to our high school students, which is from grade 9 to 12. The program curriculum is designed by senior faculty from leading universities around the world. So the curriculum is designed by alumni from top universities like Stanford, Harvard Business School, UC Berkeley, IITs and IIMs. And if you are curious to know more about artificial intelligence and how you can build up a smart device out of it, or through biological systems, then YTS will help you explore all these nuances of technology with fundamentals of computation, also the hardware interfaces, because you're going to work on end-to-end project building. This is not just the project work, but you'll also be going through interactive seminars and hands-on projects throughout. To move ahead, we have faculty, eminent faculties from all over the globe. So the curriculum runs in a four parallel track. In the first track, we in the first half of the 2 week period, students will learn from global academicians, where we are not going to have a typical theoretical sessions, but this will be more about questioning and understanding why on the problem, and how to approach the problem from different perspectives, and also how to implement strategies to solve a real world problem, right? In the first half itself, we'll be introducing kids to fundamentals on the programming, or how to interface it and build with microcontrollers. And then on the second half of the 2 week period, that's the next 1 week, full 1 week, they'll be building hands-on projects. So this will be, that's the core of the program. So next week is the core of the program, wherein you're going to apply all those fundamental concepts to build, different projects that you get to choose from. So previous year, we have seen projects being built on, ECG machine, that's electrocardiogram, making a self-balancing robot, making a teleoperated rover, then certain intelligent game designs, and also even cryptography. So it's very exciting to see these young kids as young as ninth grade and 10th graders to learn, how they can capture the electric signals that's originating from your heart, to writing a software problem programs for mathematical transformation and then visualizing the data to build a fully functional ECG monitoring device, right? So these are the kind of, core robotics and in-depth scientific smart devices the students get to work on, right? Not just that, we have very exciting, kind of a project which is known as EMG machine, wherein they learn how to harness the muscle power and which they can control for precision through an origami hand and stimulate the activities around. So all these kind of application of technology, those kind of devices that we see around ourselves, will be making it end to end in this kind of a program. So moving ahead, so apart from these exciting projects that we will be offering you to select and make, there'll be certain other non-instructional kind of sessions which will be majorly focused around interactive workshop sessions or mentorship sessions with the eminent industry leaders and also talent nights. So YTS program has been running for 6 years now. This will be the seventh edition. We are looking for more than 200 kids this year. Previous year also, we had 200 kids on our Mohali campus, which represented from 123 schools. And we also saw a participation of 30% female scholars. Right. So moving ahead to this year's information, this year we'll be hosting the program from June 9 to June 23rd at Plaksha University, Mohali. And we are currently running the third admission round, which is closing this Wednesday, coming Wednesday, which is March 17. The admissions are on rolling basis. We may keep the admissions rolling even after March 17, but that's the deadline we see so far. And you can always write down to me anytime for any query in case we're not able to settle it here. I have a little, kind of a glimpse of previous year's YTS, which I'd like to, just play for everyone to know how it actually happens at YTS.
This is the sixth edition of YTS, and it's the first time we are holding YTS at...
Sorry, are you able to hear it as well?
The Plaksha University campus in Mohali. This is a great opportunity for students to discover how to build stuff that is relevant to our society. At YTS, our endeavor has been to pick up problems that are relevant, that translate into real product and have an impact on people's lives. For many of the students, this is the first time they will be building something end to end.
YTS was conceived 6 years ago to capture the spirit on understanding how to teach the kids that disciplines are integrated and how they come together to solve really complex real-world situations.
Which means bringing together knowledge of various subjects, mechanical engineering, computing, electronics, and applying it to a problem that currently is a live problem out there.
Hello everyone. Today we present to you the AgBot. The AgBot is a four-wheeled rover that is remote controlled and can be made to move around a field. It has a camera sensor that can detect the number of plants in an image, and it can also connect to various Bluetooth-enabled sensors across the field and gather data about the field. We use components like an Arduino, a Raspberry Pi, two motor drivers, and four motors to create this project.
EMG is electromyography, and basically the project is we use electric signals that generated when we move a muscle, and we use these signals to move a robotic arm. And our whole project was based on making the arm work on lifting different loads, which are some uses of the project. Our project, Teleop, is a blend of hardware, software, and gyro sensors. We use gyro sensors to give instructions to our teleoperation car to make it move, and give instructions for it to move forward, backward, left, or right. We have used ultrasonic sensor in order to make a range so that the teleoperator car does not crash into some object.
Thank you, and would love to have what are your thoughts, and be posting my admission link here. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks a lot, Priyanka, for sharing a glimpse of what exactly the summer school looks like. Next up, we have Dr. Anurag Goswami from Bennett University. He's an associate professor and assistant dean for admissions and outreach. He holds a PhD in software engineering from North Dakota State University and has extensive experience in academia and industry. His research spans empirical software engineering, requirement engineering, and cognitive psychology, with notable publications and accolades. Dr. Goswami's work influences software engineering education and practice, marked by his dedication to advancing the field through research and teaching. Over to you, Dr. Goswami.
Okay, fantastic. Can you hear me, and can you see my screen as well?
Yes, we can.
Okay, fantastic. So, good evening, everybody, and thank you very much for joining on a Friday evening. So we are from Bennett University, that is from Times Group, in one of the India's oldest and famous, you know, media group. You can see some of the logos that you guys know. These are belongs to Times Group. And this time we are launching a summer program for the students of class 9 to 12. And it starts at 10th June and 22nd June. So who are the students who should participate in this summer program? So let me give you a scenario. So as we move forward as a student in our, you know, professional career, the transition, there are certain transition phases. And in those transition phases, you know, as we move forward, the scope of selecting things or specialization becomes narrower and narrower. So let's say we are in school and we want to switch to a professional college and then to a professional university system. So we have to understand that what are the things that happens in industry, what are the skill gaps in the academy and industry, and what are the skills that are required by the industry overall. So if we get exposed to a kind of mini world of college before actually getting into college by having an exposure to renowned academicians across the globe and India, industry leaders, where you can also, you know, talk to them, network with them, also get a chance to build something on your own with the help of faculty members and fellow students and the fellow students of Bennett as well, right? And the overall focus is interdisciplinary project work. So if I have to summarize, the three pillars that we are standing strong on, three pillars for this program is that, first of all, you get some insights from what is happening in the actual industry and what are the different tangents where you have to prepare yourself. You get a vibe of that. You also get a vibe of meta-learning, that is, you know, the process of learning on your own, understand the communication skill, the mathematics. A lot of people are afraid of that as well. And then when you are, you know, into peers, I would say rather working in groups, you understand people dynamics. You understand a glimpse of how things works in real world. So you are building products with the faculty, with the students, with your fellow colleagues who have joined the summer programs. And it embedded, I would say, manifest a lot of technical and non-technical skills, for example, communication. So how it works this time? So you can see that on your screen, we have three dimensions. So you can choose any one of those. For example, I am a student who is more inclined towards science and technology. I can choose on the left-hand side, science and technology, where I can explore artificial intelligence, robotics, AR, VR. Same happens with the financial domain, right? So I can look at how the data works, how the digital marketing works, how the leaders across the globe are, you know, they are functioning, and, you know, and the cryptocurrency and all those things. And if you move to the extreme right, you will find out that media is one of the biggest thing, and artificial intelligence have actually, you know, have its step across all these domains. So you can think about how you can go ahead with mobile journalism, how you can understand the gaming law and sports law with the help of AI maybe, and the social media, one of the biggest catch now in the media industry. So all these programs are designed by the faculty members, you know, with the help of industrial people at Bennett. And you get a chance to explore the entire infrastructure of Bennett that involves, you know, DGX V100 supercomputer, that involves, you know, humanoids, robots, the Times Lab, right? So depending on what kind of work you are doing, you get a chance to actually explore those labs and utilize those labs to build your products. If you look at this slide, you will find out certain more cards apart from project work. And if you look at the bottom one specifically, so we will have, you know, during the weekend. So it's like in the entire day, you start with the academicians and industrial, you know, exposure. Then you will have some parallel sessions across those three dimensions, that how to learn, you know, how to become a better learner, how to write better. It involves, you know, overall communication skills, I would say rather. Some of the inspirational stories, you get to go with the project work. And then maybe during the weekends, you get a chance to explore the cultural events. You get a chance to, you know, work with the sports complex that we have, state of the art sports complex. And we also have a project showcase at the end where you guys will be presenting your products to the people, maybe faculties, parents, everybody, industrial people, who will give you some feedback. And then you will, you know, it gives a confidence, it gives a motivation that, okay, we are thinking in the right direction. And I find myself, you know, working in, let's say, in, you know, Google or Facebook or Microsoft after 5-6 years, who knows, right? So you can see from left to right. So on the left, you will find out that sports activity. In the center, you will find out the cultural events. And on the right-hand side, you will find out the project expo that will take place for you all, right? So it's a very multidisciplinary, very fun, you know, environment. And let me give you a glimpse of the Bennett campus through a small video, maybe less than a minute, but I think that will give you a great exposure. And all this program is fully residential. So you will be staying at Bennett. You will be eating food, you will be exploring the classrooms, you will be interacting 24/7 with the faculty members, you will make new friends. I think one of my colleagues also said that earlier, which is very important because you have to work with different people in the industries. So let's look at those that. All right, so you have got, you know, a small glimpse, but I would suggest to go to the link that I have sent everybody on this chat box. You can directly scan and apply to this program. So you will be, you know, once again, it's a fully residential campus. So you'll be staying with us in the campus, and the application fee is $500. The overall program fee is $75,000. And for more details, you can contact Deepshikha. I will put her name and email ID in the chat box as well. So I'm good to go. Let me know in case of any questions. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Dr. Goswami. I think just looking at all of the glimpses from different universities just makes me think about my time when I was also attending one such summer school. Again, so coming back, we have the last speaker for today who is from GD Goenka University, Gurugram. So we have Pushpa Joshi, who's the Deputy Director of Admissions and Outreach at GD Goenka University. She has 19 plus years of professional experience in leading admissions, community outreach, and brand building for reputed organizations. She's also been engaged in international IBCIE education systems, corporate training, and HRM. She's created and executed engagement strategies for more than 350 top high schools across the country. So that's a great profile. Once again, again, welcome, welcome, Ms. Joshi. Over to you.
Thank you so much, Parul. So without taking much time, because I think I'm the last presenter and students must already be tired on a Friday evening, I'll just quickly share my screen and would present the presentation. I hope you're able to see my screen.
Yes.
All right. As you all know, this is Pushpa Joshi. I represent the GD Goenka University. We are a multi-dimensional, we are a multidisciplinary university. We are based in Gurgaon. So we are very near the Gurugram city, within the city limits. We offer programs from engineering to medical allied sciences, to law, to hospitality and culinary arts, and agricultural technology and liberal arts. So it's a multidisciplinary university. We are been in this education arena for the last 29 years. At GD Goenka, schools are very, very well known. So I'm sure most of you must have heard about the GD Goenka group. The university, I would just quickly show you a glimpse before we talk about the summer school at the university. One second. So as you all can see, it's a beautiful university campus. It's 60 acres of campus right at the foothills of Aravali in Gurgaon. And we are within the city limits. So if you are traveling anywhere from India, we are just 30, 35 minutes away from the Indira Gandhi International Airport. And the campus is very approachable. So we, at the Goenka University, we host this summer school every year. Last year, we had seen students coming from over 25 schools across India. And the main aim of the program is to give students an opportunity to dive deeper into a career option. So most of the time, students, when they choose a career option, they are not really aware what does it actually mean to live that life as a professional. We choose careers basis imagination or basis our what is in my mind. Sometimes students think that being a fashion designer may be very easy, becoming a chef may be an easier job, or maybe computer science is the best profession. It gets you paid well, so I should take that. However, a career is a choice that should be made basis what your inner heart calls out for. So usually what we say, if you do something that you love to do, your journey will be much easier and success will be easier to come by. So we, through the summer school, we try to give children that opportunity to explore and find out and see whether this is the career that I really want to do. So the summer school is offered on in two batches on from 3rd to 8th June and 24th to 29th June. This is a 1 week long immersive experience where the children will get to choose one of the career options that they are planning to explore. So let's say if you want to become a designer, then you can choose the summer school for design. If you want to become a chef, you can choose the summer school in the hospitality and culinary school. If you want to be a lawyer, you can choose the summer school with law. So during the summer school, you will be able to experience that particular profession that maybe today your priority number one when it comes to career. Because we all have some priorities. We all know, and our priorities may change in the future. But today, all of us have thought, maybe this is what I want to become. So you choose that area, and you'll be able to experience that profession for 1 week as part of university. You will not only understand how does the life of professionals in that area look like. You will be doing hands-on workshops. You will be meeting faculty. You will be meeting people from the industry who will tell you what do they do every day, day in and day out. What does a lawyer do? What does a fashion designer do? What does a chef do? Or what does a computer science engineer do? So that you understand whether is this what you really are thinking yourself to get involved in the future. So it's actually what I call your opportunity to try your career on. Because the smallest choices in life we make by trying it on. We go to a mall, we try a piece of clothing on. We go to a restaurant, we taste a little bit and say, okay, what is it that I want to order? But when it comes to career, you hardly have those opportunities. And I'm thankful that most universities are realizing this. And that's why you heard so many impressive speakers today. So our university also gives you this opportunity to try one of your priority careers on so that you understand whether this is the real career you want to know. I will say that you will not be really able to say that, okay, this is what I want to do. But I can tell you for sure that you will have clarity that, all right, this is what I don't want to do. And I think that's quite a great achievement in case you know what you don't want to do. Of course, this is not only focused on careers, because when the students are coming here, they are here with us 24/7 for entire 1 week. So they get to do a whole lot of activities beyond academic. We go for trekking. We have a movie night in the open air theater. You have a gala dinner that the students will plan and execute and implement. You go to heritage visits, a car museum, and you engage in indoor and outdoor sports activities. So all in all, it's an overall program where you meet a lot of students, do hands-on workshops, and you get certificate for all the workshops that you do so that they can go into your portfolio if you are applying to any college in India or overseas. So most colleges need a portfolio, so the certification will help you a lot. So students coming to the culinary and hospitality school will get a European certification from Le Cordon Bleu. Students coming to the design school will get a certification from UIT. Students coming to the engineering school will be getting a certification with Microsoft and IBM on the certificate. So that's going to add a lot of value to your candidature when you apply to the top universities. And all in all, I can say that when you meet students from across the country, you make friends for life, because here you share life with them. You have fun and you learn and you engage. It's a wholesome experience. I'm sure you're going to have a lot of learning beyond academic. As I said, we focus on a lot of personality grooming, because the 21st century skills, to get employable, you need a whole lot more than technical skills and knowledge, which is leadership, critical thinking, reading skills, farming, compassion, team building, public speaking. These are the skills that you will need. And we have a dedicated program of life skills through the summer program where experts from the industry come and share with you how to dress, what is executive presence, how to dress for an occasion, how to plan an event, how to work with team in case you have face issues. So you will be doing a whole lot of stuff there. Now I'm quickly sharing the slides on which are the programs which are available with us. So we have from the School of Agricultural Sciences, you'll be doing Harvest Harmony, where you'll be exploring garden farming, organic farming, and food production in the future. How is it going to look like? In Engineering and Sciences, you will be Eco Adventure, Tech Trek, Empowering Tomorrow's Eco Warriors, so which is a technology-based program. In aerospace engineering, you will be learning what is aerospace engineering and what all kind of careers can you make here. We have a liberal arts school where you'll be doing psychology, economics, and sociology, immersive experience into those areas of study. Law, where you will be learning how to be safe in this world of digital space, because that's the biggest challenge a lot of not only young teens but adults are facing. And when you go out to college, I think to be digitally secure is one of the most important factors. Then we have management, where you will be learning how to manage your money from the basic steps of how to open a bank account, how to manage your bank account, or to how to manage your funds as a young professional as you graduate college and inside college as well as a student. In medical allied sciences, you'll be learning about the various fields beyond MBBS. So when it comes to pharmacy, biotechnology, microbiology, biomedical engineering, these are the areas you will be exposed to. The next school that we have is hospitality and tourism, where you'll be learning culinary as well as hospitality skills. So culinary means cooking and baking. So any students who are exploring and want to become chefs or want to become food bloggers or want to start a restaurant or a cafe, those students must look at hospitality and tourism, and you get a LCB Cordon Bleu certified certification here. And we have another creative school, which is the School of Design. So students who are looking at becoming, fashion designers, product designers, or taking up gaming and graphic designing or communication design, they can look at the School of Design. Indoor and outdoor activities, as you saw, the campus is a huge 60-65 acre campus where you have a lot of indoor-outdoor activities. So students have to mandatorily choose one indoor and one outdoor activity as part of the course. The program is a 1 week long program and the fees is 25,000 include. It's a fees for non-boarders. If you want to take residence, then you'll have to pay 10,000 more, which makes the fees with boarding to 35,000. And we have an early bird waiver going on, which is a 10% waiver. If you join the first 100 students, we are looking at a total of 200 students in this cohort, in both the batches together. So that's about the program. And thank you so very much for giving me this time and for your attention. I am just going to share the application link in the chat box. In case you have any questions for me, I've shared my number, or in case you would like to ask me, I'm here. Thank you so very much.
Thank you so much, Ms. Joshi. That was indeed very insightful for all the students. And I think we are about to reach the end of our, you know, duration for the summer, you know, school event. So, but I think I still have a question from the audience, and it's about the prerequisites. So they're asking that, are there any prerequisites or specific academic requirements for students to participate in your summer school program, other than the fact that, you know, they have to be in certain classes? So anyone?
No. So we don't have any prerequisites because this is an opportunity for students to experience. We don't expect them to come with any pre-knowledge, any pre-interest. Even if they have not done anything, they can come and choose that area. And students in my program can join from 13 years of age to 19 years of age.
Okay, thank you so much. Yeah. Anyone else would like to answer that question?
Yeah, same with Bennett as well. No prereqs, but again, 9 to 12 standard students.
Okay.
Yeah, I would add on to it. I am looking for people from 9 to 12, but the more emphasis would be eagerness or inquisitiveness to know things, enthusiasm, and energy to participate. That's always the primary requirement for us.
That's great. Thanks on the qualitative, you know, qualities of a student. Wonderful.
Yeah, same for University's YTS. And you just need to have a passion to solve a real world problem using technology. The coding, the knowledge of coding or microcontrollers is not at all necessary. Everything that you are going to use in while building your project will be taught before in the program itself. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. And similarly for Universal AI as well. So we don't require the students to have any kind of a prior, you know, knowledge about AI or any of these things, because we rather want the students to actually explore their interests in the field of AI. So how they want to go link AI to the career. So you would actually like to help them about how they can, you know, explore the field of AI. So yeah.
Thank you. Thank you so much. We have asked...
Just to summarize for you, I believe everyone has a similar requirement of 9 to 12.
Correct.
Which is the academic qualification, and the rest is all qualitative, no? I mean,
right.
Inquisitiveness and an open mind. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you so much, Abhyuday. We have Ashu raising their hand. Ashu, can you please go ahead and type your question in the chat box or in the Q&A? All right. So let us just in the end talk a little bit about, you know, what are the safety measures, or how do you ensure the safety and the well-being of students who are participating in the summer school, especially, you know, if they're out of town? Anyone who would like to take that up?
So once the students are in the campus, we since it is a residential program, students are within the boundaries of the campus. Everything is available inside the campus. So as you saw the video also, it's a mini town inside this campus. So we have multiple eating joints along with the college mess. They get everything inside the campus. And of course, the campus is CCTV, under CCTV surveillance, and it's completely secure. We have 3,000 students on the campus staying with the faculty. So it's a completely secure, you know, place. When it comes to students arriving from outside the city, we do give pick and drop facility from either the airport or the railway station. So, and we also drop the child back once the program is over in case the parents request. Usually the parents come to drop, but outstation children come with, if they inform us, we will pick and drop.
Thank you.
I would say the same thing with Alliance University as well. It's a residential program, and we take full responsibility of it, because the same thing, like, it's a campus where more than 3,000 students are staying 24/7, and we have everything within the campus. And every tour or any within the city, we will be taking them for industry visit and everything. It could be all guided by the people, and it's and it's a 24/7 thing, which is like we do it every day. It's not a first timer.
Yeah.
So yes.
So adding to it, if I
little
start tell about to, yeah, please go ahead. No problem.
I'd like to clarify on this juncture that for Atlas Kintec University, it is not a mandate to be a residential program, because for students from the city of Bombay, they can travel day in and day out. For students from outside the city, hostel is available, but again, it's not a mandate. They can choose to stay with their relatives or someone near the campus. That's up to them. Hostel is available at their perusal. If they want to stay, they can put up at the hostel. The security in the campus and at the hostel is top-notch. I mean, the best that you can think about, and all the possible means of ensuring that children are safe, they have a cut-off time to the hostel, and all of that is there. And the security is to an extent that we have a 3-shift sniffer dog available in the hostel, along with a metal detector scanning area chain, right? So yeah, and the security is ensured to that extent.
Awesome. That's good to know from everyone. Thank you so much for your inputs. I think that there are no more questions, and you've already answered all the questions that were there in the Q&A section. So thank you so much for that. And again, in the end, I'm assuming that everyone has taken notes, very diligent notes a lot of information that was displayed in front of you. And you're also making sure that, you're checking out the chat box, because every one of our, 7 speakers, they've gone ahead and shared a bunch of different links, even their contact information. So please make sure that you note that down and go ahead and contact them in case, you're interested in exploring what, the summer school is all about. So, and let me tell you, from my own personal experience, this is not just something that, you will derive benefit out from in 1 week or 10 days. This is something that actually goes on to get added onto your profile, right? And shows a lot of things, from proactiveness to, leadership. And just in terms of building a very holistic personality, I think getting enrolled into a summer school of this stature, it's extremely important in today's day and age. Thank you so much once again to all of our amazing panelists. Thank you so much for sparing time. And thank you to each and every one of our audience members. I hope the session has benefited you all. Thank you once again, and have a great day.
Thank you.
Thanks, everyone.
Have a great weekend.
Thanks for hosting.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Bye.